Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's Amin here, of course, from Seerah Masters. I hope you're doing well. Ramadan Mubarak. May Allah accept all of your good deeds and our good deeds. So in a couple of days, inshallah, I'm going to go live with a very exciting project that I've been working on for the last year, on and off. And actually, it's been kind of quiet. I've had very small mentions of it on the podcast and stuff like that. But in a few days, I'm going to go more live with it, okay? It's not fully ready, but inshallah, it'll be something where you can see what's in the works, you can see what's coming, and I think it's really exciting for anyone interested in kind of mindset, developing the ummah, personal development, stuff like that. So the project, you're going to find out all the details in a couple of days, inshallah, and I'll be putting out further videos about it. But I just wanted to answer the question, why did I decide to work on this topic? Okay, because the project is all around the Islamic model for masculinity. Okay, and I just wanted to explain, like, why do I think it's important? People might be wondering, like, why is it important? Like, surely, for example, we should just be good Muslims and that's enough, right? So I think the first reason that I got interested in this topic is because on this channel I was giving a lot of, you know, the kind of ideas and advice that I've come across and I found beneficial or I found very interesting. And I've always been sharing that with you, and I've done that for several years now, alhamdulillah. I've actually made over 250 videos on this channel, alhamdulillah. So that's really good. And when I was giving this advice and these ideas, I did deep down feel, according to my, you know, values and my culture, that a lot of the advice I was giving was man-centric or masculine-centric. And when I say masculine, what I mean by that is it was very about getting very organized, very focused, very tunnel vision on high performance and productivity and sometimes business, sometimes career, and looking at studies in a masculine way, which means it's all about, not all about, but a lot about getting a job at the end and stuff like that. And, you know, deep down, I did feel like sometimes, you know, a good amount of the audience are women. But yet, deep down, I didn't feel fully comfortable, like I was giving them the best advice for a Muslim woman. And so I just kind of felt like, yeah, my stuff maybe is more geared towards the men. At the same time, when I used to be on Twitter and stuff, I used to often come across, and I still come across it on YouTube and stuff, this concept that, you know, men and, you know, in the Muslim sphere, like Muslim men, are kind of failures, okay? Whether they're called having, you know, egos that are out of control, whether they're called, you know, misogynist or abusive, you know, sometimes you hear of so-and-so, he's abusive and this and that, or whether you just talk about men being irresponsible or controlling. And some of these things, I think there's a lot of truth to them, and that's a big problem. That's almost a crisis in the ummah, and we have to see it as a crisis for the ummah and not for men, okay? Because men having problems and having failures in, for example, taking responsibility, that is a big problem for the women and the children of the ummah as well, of course. So some of that has truth to it, and some of it I feel is just men being men and men being men in a correct fashion, actually. But yet the average Muslim man or woman, they're not really aware of the Islamic model for masculinity. Like, okay, you feel this is abusive, or you feel like this is extreme, or you feel like this is too aggressive, but what does Islam have to say about that? And as far as I know, there's literally no understanding of this amongst Muslims, right? Especially in the English-speaking world. I think some more traditional cultures have, you know, for hundreds of years, they've kept certain principles of, you know, what it means to be a man and stuff. And a lot of the time that is correct, and sometimes that kind of goes out of hand. But the point is that it's not really, people are not really aware of what did the Prophet ﷺ expect men to be like? What does Allah expect men to be like? What are the traits of a good Muslim man? Right? And notice that I say good Muslim man, okay? Not just man, not just like masculine, right? Because sometimes masculine traits can be used in a negative way, but a good Muslim man, those three things, putting them together. So basically, just a lot of criticism of men. Some of it is correct, some of it is just completely incorrect. But in order to determine what is right and wrong, we need to understand what being masculine means for us Muslims. Okay, so that was another reason I was interested in it. Another reason was feminism, really. You know, we've got more and more feminism is seeping into the minds of the average Muslim in the West and outside of the West. And it was always something that I felt mostly uncomfortable with. Of course, there are principles of feminism that are in line with Islam, and that's fine. But, you know, a large part of feminism and all the different types of feminism kind of go against a lot of Islamic principles and just general values, right? And so feeling uncomfortable with it, I also became very aware that I often didn't have good, strong arguments against some of these things that feminists were arguing for, right? And so that kind of made me say sometimes silly things on Twitter, which I couldn't, you know, I couldn't back, you know, I couldn't add any juice behind what I was saying. And eventually it made me just go quiet on the topic, okay? So I would just say, look, I can't enter this conversation in a credible way, you know what I mean? So I left that, and then I've left Twitter since then and everything. But it did stay in my mind, like, okay, so I think these feminists are wrong. Surely I should be able to prove them wrong. You know, if I'm right in that a lot of these feminist ideas are incorrect, and not just incorrect, but bad for the ummah, bad for the family unit, bad for the individual, whether it's the man or the woman. Right? I truly believe that, by the way. Like, it's bad for the individual, man and woman, it's bad for the family unit, and it's bad for the ummah at large, okay? But if that is true, I should be able to prove it. And surely Allah would have given us guidance around this topic, right? Of, in 2020, how to engage with feminism. What part of feminism is true, what is false. And so that kind of made, that feminism thing made me kind of defensive, and it made me then look for what is, how should a man be? Like, you're criticizing men for being like XYZ. I don't really agree with you, but why don't I agree with you? Let me go out there and see what Islam actually has to say. And very importantly in this project is I had to have an open mind. I had to be willing to have my mind changed. I had to be willing to be uncomfortable. And alhamdulillah, I think I've done that. What I have gained, what I've learned so far in this project, mostly, you know, more than half has been reaffirming some of these traditional values that all of humanity often holds. But then some of it has been quite paradigm shifting in how I see the way a man should be. So these are just some of the reasons that I decided to focus on this topic of Muslim or the Islamic model for masculinity. How should a good Muslim man be? What is his role? And what are the traits of a man? You know, and yeah, so that's why I'm in this. That's why I decided to kind of spend quite a lot of time working on this. And I think for the foreseeable future, I will be kind of focusing on it. And I also do think it's very beneficial to the men and the women. You know, I don't think it's something just for men. I think men should pay attention. And often men need to be very open and need to put their ego aside and just be saying to themselves, like, look, I need to develop. Like me, Amin, I need to develop. You know, Mr. Sira Masters, I need to develop, I need to improve myself. And I think that's the biggest barrier a lot of men have, is they don't see the need to develop and improve themselves. So hopefully, yani, a man speaking to a man who is on the same wavelength as a lot of men, and trying to be balanced and come from an Islamic perspective, inshallah, I can put information out there that will ultimately help Muslim men develop themselves, become closer to Allah, become better people, and also help the Muslim family unit in general. Thanks for watching. This has been Amin, of course, with Sira Masters, and keep your eyes peeled for future videos, because in a couple of days, in the description box below, you're going to see the link to that campaign, to that project, where you can find out a lot of juicy details, inshallah. See you around, and assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.